It's important to recognize that covalent bonds have varying bond strengths and bond lengths depending on what atoms are bound together in the covalent bond. The strength of a covalent bond is measured by its disassociation energy. Disassociation energy is the energy, the amount of energy required to separate two bound atoms. So different bonds have different disassociation energies. Bonds that require a lot of energy to break are called strong bonds, and relatively speaking, bonds that require less energy to break are considered weak bonds. We can think about disassociation energy in the context of potential energy. This rough sketch is a sketch of potential energy versus internuclear distance. In this case, when we have two atoms that are far apart in space, they would have no potential energy. This would be considered the minimum or zero potential energy. As the two atoms move closer and closer together, that is, as their internuclear distance decreases, they will achieve some minimum potential energy where they are as close as possible to minimize their energy. If you continue to try to force those two atoms closer together in space, their potential energy will shoot up as the nuclei will repel each other. So this difference between the minimum potential energy that exists between two atoms that are covalently bound together and the energy of the two atoms completely separated, this difference here is what we would call the disassociation energy. The amount of energy it takes to move from the atoms that are bound together to the separated atoms. We can look at this simulation to help us understand this notion of how the potential energy changes depending on how close or how far apart atoms are to one another. In this case, first, let's look at iodine. If I have the two iodine atoms together in a diatomic molecule, iodine, molecular iodine, I can see that they will reside at some minimum potential energy. I can pull those atoms apart and see that as I pull them apart, their potential energy is increasing until I add enough energy such that they are no longer bound together. But if those two atoms are allowed to come close together in space, they will attach such that they both have achieved this minimum potential energy in their system. If I continue to try to push those atoms closer together, then their potential energy will increase again due to the repulsive nature of the nuclei. Different atoms in covalent bonds, that their potential energy well is different. See, iodine, the distance between the bottom of the well and the separated atoms is less than that for bromine. And so what we would say, since the disassociation energy is the amount of energy it takes to separate, go from the minimum potential energy to the potential energy of the separated atoms, and the well is bigger for bromine, we'd say that bromine-bromine molecule has a stronger bond than iodine. And then chlorine has an even stronger bond, as you can see that it would take even more energy to separate chlorine into its individual. Bond energies have been tabulated, and you can look at a table similar to this of bond energies. They're typically reported in units of kilojoules per mole of bonds, not energy units per individual, but per mole of bonds. And you can read the table like this. For example, a carbon-carbon single bond has a bond energy of 346 kilojoules per mole, whereas a fluorine-fluorine bond is 155, a chlorine-chlorine 242, bromine-bromine 193, iodide-iodide 151. And we saw when we looked at the simulation that the potential energy well for chlorine was deeper than for iodine. And you can see that reflected in these tabulated values that the chlorine-chlorine has a higher bond energy. Therefore, we would say it is a stronger bond. You can also look at bond energies of multiple bonds, the carbon-carbon versus the carbon-carbon double bond, 346 to 602 to the carbon-carbon triple bond, 835. And from this, we can see that multiple bonds are stronger as you increase the order of the multiple bond. Here we see it again between carbon and nitrogen and carbon-nitrogen triple bond. In addition to bond strengths, we want to think about bond lengths. And in general, the bond strength and bond length correlate in that the shorter the bond, the stronger the bond in general. This holds for multiple bonds. A carbon-carbon single bond has a bond length of 154 picometers for the carbon-carbon single bond, whereas a carbon-carbon double bond, I'll write it over here, is 134 picometers, and the carbon-carbon triple bond is 120 picometers. So you can see that as the bond becomes stronger, the bond length becomes shorter. Now, in the case of the different atoms, in general, the bond length correlates with bond strength, but not always, because we know that the fluorine-fluorine bond length is 142 picometers, whereas the chlorine-chlorine is 199 picometers. The bromine-bromine is 228 picometers, and the iodine-iodine is 268 picometers. So what we see here is that bond length is defined as the internuclear distance between the two nuclei of bound atoms in a covalent bond. And typically, the smaller the atomic radii, the shorter the bond length. And we see this in the fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. We know as we go down the periodic table that the atomic radii increase. And we see this in the case of the fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine down the periodic table, that these diatomics, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine, their bond lengths increase as one would expect with the size of the atoms that are in the bonds. So in general, bond strength and bond length varies with the size of the atoms bound together. In general, the shorter the bond length, the stronger the bond. We see there are some molecule or some covalent bonds that do not follow this pattern. For example, fluorine, but that typically occurs when you have some many. It's a small atom and it's got many unshared pairs of electrons, which serve to destabilize that particular bond, making it weaker than one would have predicted based on its length. Multiple bonds between the like atoms are shorter and stronger than the lesser bonds between like atoms, and that pattern, that trend, holds for all series of multiple bonds.